What's up, everyone, and welcome to another episode of Word on the River. I'm your host, Clancy Burke, and today I went around campus and asked students all about the riveting, fun topic of college apps. I know a lot of you out there are still in the process. It's not easy, it's hard, I feel for you, but don't worry, you're gonna get through it, and proof of that is the fact that I'm here, and if I can get through it, so can you. But yeah, I thought it'd be cool just to kind of ask, you know, the Marist student body what their thoughts were and how their process went and what they hated, what they loved, even some tips. Wow, my phone just vibrated. I'm so popular. So let's go see what they have to say.
I know it was so long ago for you, but what do you remember the most about applying to colleges?
My parents pushing me to apply to 8 different colleges other than Marist and one in Florida, because I'm from Florida. So they're like, you have to apply at least for one in home.
It's just a really stressful and overwhelming process.
I just remember being really nervous, and I wanted to go to Marist so badly. So I was just really focused, and I just gave it everything I had, really.
Definitely a lot of frustration. That's what I felt.
You felt a lot of frustration?
Yeah. Just like constant annoyances. Mom nagging me to get my applications done. Didn't get them done till like a week before I was due, to be honest with you.
It was a lot of work, but I actually only applied to 2 places, here being one of them. I did early decision. So it was a very stressful time, and I was very unsure about if I actually wanted to do an early decision because it's a big commitment. But my advisor said, Laura, if you really like this place, you should do it if it's your number one choice.
To be honest, I don't really remember too much.
What was your least favorite part about applying to colleges?
Oh my gosh. Probably figuring out what to write for the essay. The personal essay. I just didn't know. It's like describe yourself and everything like you do in life in 500 words or less. You know what I mean?
Oh, the tediousness of it.
Waiting for the schools to reply back.
I think I answered this.
Did I?
I'm like not kidding. I think I said like writing essays and applying. Come on, Clancy, get your act together.
We didn't really go over it much in school, so I was pretty much left to do it on my own. My parents helped me out a little bit, and that's it.
Gotta love mom and dad, am I right?
Yeah, definitely.
I guess just the stress and taking all the standardized tests.
Were you one of those early action, ahead of the game people, or were you just regular?
No, I put it off to the last minute. I didn't even make my decision. I think it was like the last day that you could.
I was ahead of the game 100%.
Oh, okay.
I was an early decision. I was way ahead, got my acceptance letter a day before my birthday, actually, on December 18th.
That's a good birthday present.
It definitely was.
A regular, pretty much, except for Marist. I did apply early action for Marist, yeah.
I got my application done pretty early because I was pretty sure, you know, that this was the place for me, so I want to just get it done early.
And were you right?
Yes. I'm right. I'm a senior now, unfortunately. It's gone by really fast, but I was right. I picked the absolute perfect place for me, and I knew it back then, and I know now.
How many schools in total did you apply to?
I think I applied to over 22 schools.
3, I think. I had 10 schools.
7.
12 colleges.
Only Marist.
Oh my God. That's like confidence, you know?
You would get in.
Oh, okay, okay. Was Marist always your first choice?
Yeah, actually from the day I was a freshman in high school. This was my first school that I ever toured, so I loved it from the beginning.
Yeah. Marist is my first pick. My dad works here. Like, it's close to home. I love it. The campus is beautiful. Everyone's so nice.
I didn't want to come to Marist at first. My mom really pushed me to come, and then I came and visit after I got in, and I was like, thank God, because after coming here, I didn't want to go anywhere else.
It was the first school I came to look at for an open house, and they set kind of like a high standard, so yeah, it was the first school I looked at and the first choice I had. I
just came with my dad, and we walked around. He's like, yeah, this is a good place, son, so I ended up coming here.
Always trying to please your dad?
Yeah, I guess so. Got to keep the family happy, right?
Yeah. What is one tip that you'd give to everyone out there currently applying to college?
Start looking at schools early and make sure that you get everything in on time.
Oh my gosh, should I look at the camera when I say this?
Just keep at it and keep your hopes up. That's 100%.
Stay strong. Everything happens for a reason. And don't get discouraged by anything or anyone.
Diversify your resume. Find something that's unique about you and then really sell it.
Just keep going and you'll end up at the right school. There's a school out there for everybody.
Visit schools. Go visit a lot of schools. Even if they look cool online and you feel like you don't need to visit, go visit them because you might have a different feeling when you actually step on the campus.
Don't get too nervous because it'll work out.
If you come to Marist and you get that feeling of just home, community, you know, just like this is a place for you, just go for it. The application process is really tough, but stick through it because once you get here, it is just the best and you feel so, it's just such a rewarding feeling of accomplishment and you just feel great when you're here. So good luck.
Thank you guys so much for watching. And if you enjoyed, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. And if you have a question that you want answered or any recommendations or requests, be sure to tweet at us using the hashtag #WordOnTheRiver. or even drop a comment down below and we'll be sure to get you in on the fun. Also, don't forget to follow Marist on all things social media. So, you know, we got Instagram, Twitter, we even have Snapchat. That's how, like, in the know we are, because Snapchat's pretty cool. But I'm gonna go for now, and until next time, have a wonderful, wonderful day. Bye.